American poetry. They are the authors, each of them, of multiple books published by excellent presses. And the best way to get to know these poets, of course, is by reading those books. They will be for sale after the reading. You can pick them up and the poets will sign them. We'll have a book signing. We hope you'll stick around for that. We're going to read in alphabetical order, and I'd like to ask each of the poets to say your name and also the title of your most recent book and anything else that you'd like to say. And there'll be a question and answer after the reading, so think of some questions while the poets are up here, and enjoy the reading. The first reader is Mark Bibbins.
Thank you, and thank you, Deborah, and NYU, and this beautiful bookstore. And no questions. This is one poem from The Dance of No Hard Feelings, which is the book I was supposed to mention to you, and which I did. This is called Redemption. Here's another rack on which to hang your critical coat. A flight over the plain states keeps going and no one notices. The ride is so smooth. Even the inevitable drop into the Pacific is of no more moment than the twitch of a sleeping cat's ear. There's a pack of kids on a nearby aircraft carrier talking about kicking the crap out of someone, though all I keep hearing is, I can't activity when you, with you, when I'm, you, I'm, adjective. He likes it that there is no chance to misunderstand Pansy, Gertrude Stein. That was ages ago, when everyone's predilections could spread unchecked and without consequence. We flourished, all dirty and dazzling as tranny hookers under the Manhattan Bridge. Yes, but can you, adjective, when you're, I'm not, can you, adjective, when you're not, what if you were slightly, adjective, today, in the great corporate slideshow of the heart, the bullet points are blanks. Today, though I am feeling positively artisanal, I'm letting you do the work like you like to. I'm letting you pretend you're still the sun, drawing an infernal line through everything. And these are relatively newer. You don't need to know that, but you do. I don't know what you're going to do with that information. Put it to good use. This is called Pedagogy and Performance. Whatever the lesson was, it wasn't taking. We awaited the information in kind of a corporate way, and I kept wanting to go up to the whiteboard and write feminine, marvelous, and tough, and ask, is that what you're trying to do? Sometimes it's hard to figure out how to move. When cardinals move, they're as imposing as cows. They pull pornography from abstraction. But let's also look at us a few weeks ago, a scale model of Seattle with its gleaming library protruding like a jewel from a navel. This was our best self, not the contraption of drawers and cranks that made our work, not the surprisingly delicate bones of Boba Fett painted the same colors as his armor, not the three toe-headed delinquents who used the contraption in their performance, then went home after disparaging the audience and showered together, not the cast of my life filing into a wooden amphitheater as my favorite band started soundcheck in another country. How would I get there on time, even with half my friends rooting for me? How do I get anything done when, as late as last night, someone started yelling, Cardinal, at the sight of blood soaking my sleeve? This is called Breakout Session. Before we say anything else, I'd like to point out that this coverage is favorable to the user. I mean, I'm already a fan, so I trust the instructions, which seem to tell us to reject a strutting self. I'm able to choose that too. Am I wrong, or did the user leave us lots of little choices? If we're being led in wrong directions in service of larger truths, so be it. I will happily call a whole school of red herrings my family. Soon enough, something pulls me back to a photo of myself. I don't remember who took it, but it implies a phantom twin, the kind of presence you reach out to when you die. Autobiography is still the sincerest form of flattery. There were things I couldn't say before because I knew the group would agree, one of which is that I'm quite sure I've uncovered the source of this terrible light. Not quite lethal, but the user has given us a permission again. and no matter how compelling the light might be, it has some serious potential to degrade us. In the end, it's one of the user's favorite solutions. Water to water to water to sex. But I don't mind in the way I never do. He's drawn a bath for everyone, and it's almost as though I'm no longer afraid there won't be enough room. I have a question for you. It's also the title of this poem. What are predators but parasites that kill you faster? One conundrum is that you sew a bunch of ghosts together, only to end up with a smaller ghost. You mend the hem, I'll tend the holes, chomp, chomp, choke, little blood clot on the yolk. Thus you deviate as I scrape away a cleaner spot. Short digression on decorating the tree. Find a wood chipper, feed in honey, blankets, books. Treasures better decked in ketamine feathers and wet forever lemons. Hide us in a pit, rip the furtive flap, the stitched up gut. Short digression on the middle of the desert, we're in it. Under other accomplishments, you can put copycat, snottiness, Ouija, realness, and blinking when forbidden, please. Love the desert, squeeze it, take it home, put it in a cage with what's left of the ghost. Even you should admit, it's sweeter than the pet leech you used to keep. One more and then a lot more wonderful poets. This is Bowerbird. I recently rescued a supermarket bag from the crotch of a tree, found fewer shields than souvenirs, figured out how to game the pain scale and opted not to. Water the color of watery tea comes through the light fixture, observing a holiday when nobody can come plug it up and make us regret complaining. Nothing like a movie to remind you that you never travel, and a lot of almost fornicating happens a mere floor or two above the one you're on. Shoulder, TV flicker, flash of back. I'll make up a name and try to affix it to whoever left these four white doors on the sidewalk, which I dragged home two and one at a time. In daylight, they reveal the smudges left on tenants' ways from one space to the next. Hall, stairwell, street, the mess just beyond. Forest on the opposite side of the globe. There's always the absurd woven into each nest I build and hop around, waiting for the right one to wander in. The right one is the one who wanders in. Cheers.